same thing. People that are well known, they're in the papers, in the news. Usually at the end of the day, and these are the people that come in to renew it. And what I found out was they just really wanted to talk to somebody.
Yeah.
They didn't want any special treatment. God's sake, said they wanted somebody they could talk to. So during the war, since I had to be engaged in some war activity, I had the appointments for people that were important. People couldn't waste a lot of time, but everybody was busy. And so this one man came in after 5 o'clock, and he was in a business suit that looked like he'd slept in it. And so I assumed that he was one of the chip bidders, you know, because they were given special treatment. So the shipbuilding was the name. So he missed 7 questions on his test. So I thought, well, the ship bidder is working night and day, and doesn't have any sleep. I said, well, look, these are questions that everybody misses. So let's sit down and talk about it. I said, these are questions that are there because the people need to know this to be safe in driving. And there are questions that we especially had designed so that people would think about this particular danger. So he seemed to be interested, and he stayed about an hour with me. And so when he got up to leave, he said, young man, if you're ever in the financial district in San Francisco, stop by and see me. And I said, oh boy, what does he want? And so when he gave me his card, John Henry Baldwin.
It was John who?
He owned the shipyards.
What was his name?
John Henry Pomeroy.
Oh, Pomeroy. Oh.
Pomeroy. Well, how big is this man? He had the construction of shipyards.
Mm.
And he said, well, he said, I can send you down to Brazil. But he said, look, he said, this war isn't going to last much longer. But he said, if you want the experience, we'd give you a job there.
Mm.
I don't know what he was going to give me. And not until then, he handed me his card, and John Henry Palmer.
Wow.
One of the richest men in the country. And he just wanted to sit down and talk. So I thought, well, I might as well take advantage of it. I felt guilty about it. One day I thought, well, I'll go down and see him. So I got down to his office. He had the entire top of the building in his financial district. So I met the secretary, and she said, well, Mr. Pomeroy is having a corporate meeting today discussing the directors of the different shipyards. And so she said, but I'll tell him that's her interest. So she did, and she came right back. And he said, he'll meet you in the guest room.
Mm.
So I could look down through the doors in the corporate office, and here's a long table with all these 15 head guys
Wow.
seated around there. And he got up and left and came in. talked to him. He said, "Look, young man," he said, "you know what you have? There's nothing like it. And you have a position where you have an opportunity to experience many things, much more than we can ever get here." So he said, "If I were you, I wouldn't leave what you have. Stay there, and," he said, "you'll have benefits that we can't even approach." He said, "You'll have your health insurance, you'll have your retirement for the rest of your life." He said, "You've got everything that you need. And then you don't have to pay for it."
Yeah.
So he was right. He saved me from making a terrible mistake. Although it might have been during the war. I went to Brazil and had charge of this or that. He wasn't thinking about the shipyards. He was thinking about me.
Yeah, that's great.
So I've had the experience as a trial examiner. I've examined people and even in different countries. That if you meet them on the level of someone who is interested in them, and in many cases you meet people that you wonder why they take time, and I can explain that to you. A number of the top Hollywood executives have property in this part of California. They usually have a ranch or something big. So one day, the director of one of the top movies in Hollywood came in to renew his license. Again, after hours, so he could talk. So what did he want to talk about? He said, "Russ, I've read the paper about your car." He said, "I've had a car too." And he says, "You know what I miss? I don't miss it. The souvenirs from these moving pictures of that." And, you know, the sad thing was, here he is amongst them, and all of the very top people in Hollywood. No one cared about him. No one said, "Hey, I'm sorry about your car." No one even said, "Boo." And then heard him.
Yeah.
Here amongst the big shots. And just like you, if they have a meeting and someone has had an experience or that you had, they probably wouldn't take the time today to even mention it.
Yeah. Well.
So there are a lot of lonely people.
Yeah.